This is a Storm Center 4 severe weather update.
Well, good morning again from the Storm Center. I'm meteorologist Paul Huttner. This may end up being one of, if not the biggest snowstorms in Twin Cities history. Virtually the city of Minneapolis is in paralysis this morning. A lot of things are shut down. As a matter of fact, I've got some road reports here. West Metro area, snow compacted, ice under the roads, ramps are blowing shut, snowing and blowing snow. The snow is coming down heavy at this hour. Visibility is from an eighth to a quarter of a mile, and that's very, very low. I was driving in a couple of hours ago, and at times the visibilities were even less than that. So it is definitely tough going out there. We often don't say, don't travel if you don't have to, but I have to say this is one of those situations where it's very borderline. If you really do not have to travel, I would not risk it this morning. Many businesses around the metro area have been closed down. The Minneapolis public schools are closed. That gives you an idea of the ferocity of this storm. The airport out at Twin Cities International, two of the three runways are closed this morning. They have one runway open. Big delays at the airport, as you can expect. And even the MTC, they're having some trouble running. They're doing their best to keep up with the situation, but it is very slow going on the buses as well. So far at Twin Cities Airport, 16.8 inches of snow. That's an update just within the past few minutes. And we're going to break our all-time 24-hour snowfall record the way it looks. The old record is 20 inches. That was set back in January 22nd of 1982. So far, 16.8, another 4 to 6 inches of snow is a possibility, so I think we will end up over that 20-inch mark here in the Twin Cities. Other road reports from around the state, Owatonna fair to poor driving conditions, sleet and ice-covered roads. And in southwestern Minnesota, where they have the blizzard warning this morning, around Windham, roads are snow-covered and compacted, 1 to 2 foot drifts down there, visibility under a half a mile, no travel advised in southwestern Minnesota this morning. Well, let's take a look at our Doppler radar here, and I'll show you what is going on right now. We do have a large area of snow all across the eastern Minnesota, western Wisconsin. It is mostly snow, but there is a dividing line towards rain, and that line is right here. East of this line here is mostly rain. There's some sleet mixed in as well, and that would be western Wisconsin over into the southeast metro. Now, the heavier snow is right here through the eastern metro where you see that darker green. That indicates moderate to heavy snowfall at this time. But this whole area out here, still getting some heavy snow as well. And the main thing, the winds are starting to pick up this morning. They're blowing that snow around, and it's becoming increasingly difficult to travel around parts of Minnesota. We do have some tape shot from downtown Minneapolis from earlier today. And you can see the road graders are out. They're trying to keep some of the roads open, but they're having a very difficult time of it. As you can imagine, look at some of these drifts already piling up. People trying to shovel walks. As I said, most businesses that we've had reports of are closing today. So you'll want to check with your own employer, of course, to see if they're going to be open. But travel conditions are definitely on the treacherous side. And the main thing now, the winds are starting to pick up. So as they plow the roads, they're blowing shut right again with those drifts that are beginning to pile up throughout parts of the Twin Cities. It does look like the snow will continue through much of the morning. It may begin to taper off later this afternoon, but not before an additional 4 to 6 inches. And as I said, that would put us up over 20 inches. And that should set an all-time 24-hour snowfall record for the Twin Cities. Right now, we do have some advisories and warnings to talk about. Winter storm warnings, northwest Iowa, from southeastern Minnesota, including the Twin Cities, all the way up on into the Arrowhead. We have blizzard warnings for southwestern Minnesota. No travel recommended down around Windham. We have reports that there are some roads closed west of the Twin Cities. So folks in places like Redwood Falls, Sleepy Eye, Pipestone, you are under a blizzard warning this afternoon, actually for the entire day. And the main thing out there, those winds are going to be picking up out of the north and northwest. They'll be gusting from 15 to 30 miles per hour, even higher in some cases. We've already had gusts well into the 30s. Travel is going to be really tough over this entire area this afternoon. How much snow will we have? Well, it's incredible, if you can believe it. We were talking yesterday in the Weather Center, and if you need 10 ingredients to get a huge snowstorm, a lot of times we'll have 6 or 7 of the 10. This time we have 10 of the 10, and all the ingredients are there, the moisture, and it's gonna lead to some incredible snowfall totals. Lighter in western Wisconsin, you folks over in Eau Claire and even down towards Winona, we do have lighter amounts because of the rain and sleet that has been mixed in. but a band of 6 to 12 inches from Duluth down to just east of the Twin Cities and then down to around Albert Lea and Austin. And yes, this band here, 15 to 20 inches of snowfall. We've already got 16.8 here in the Twin Cities. Many spots will pick up over 20 inches, it looks like, before this thing is all over. Well, what is causing all this mess? Here's the culprit responsible. This low pressure system right here, which is just starting to work its way into southeastern Iowa. And all the snow behind it here, from the Twin Cities back to Nebraska, all the way down into the Oklahoma Panhandle, some thunder mixed in. I had a call from Anoka about a half an hour ago with some thunder snow mixed in as well. And those are what we call those snow bursts that you'll see, where it'll start lightning and thundering, and the snow will just start coming down in sheets. And we can get snowfall accumulations at the rate of 1 or 2 or even 3 inches per hour in that kind of a situation. This low is just starting to move into Iowa. It's going to race up into Wisconsin this afternoon. That's a perfect track for us to get the heavy snow, as you can expect. And the main thing behind it, the winds are going to start wrapping in from the north and northwest, and that's going to start blowing that snow around that we do have. It looks like drifting will be the major problem here, as well as additional accumulations throughout the rest of the afternoon. So once again, this may end up being the biggest snowstorm in Twin Cities history, the way it looks. Our 24-hour snowfall record was 20 inches set back in 1982. We are at 16.8 right now, and we may end up over 20 inches by the time it's all said and done. I'll keep you updated here as we go through the morning, and we do have some more tape to show you from downtown Minneapolis. Some current conditions. We have snow right now. Half a mile visibility at the airport. Temperature at 30 degrees. The dew point right up there at 28. Our humidity is 92%. Here's the main thing, though. Those winds, they're north at 28, and they're gusting to 33 miles per hour. So they are causing that snow to blow and drift. The barometer is low. It's 29.73. And as that low comes up through Wisconsin that I showed you, it will continue to fall for much of the rest of the morning. When will it end? It looks like maybe during the afternoon we'll begin to see it tapering off. I think by then things will begin to improve through this evening. But as far as the rest of the morning goes and right through the noon hour, things are looking very, very treacherous across virtually all of southern Minnesota, southwestern Minnesota, right on up into the Arrowhead. And it looks like this may end up being one of the biggest storms in Twin Cities history. I will be back here very shortly, and we will keep you posted. We're going to be on quite often this morning with weather updates, so keep it here. We will keep you posted.